It's the talk of San Diego.
How are you today? Hey, I'll be back. Here we are. Hi, Susanna.
Hi.
How are you today?
I'm fantastic.
Hey, you know, they got me at the they got me off to the side today because I kind of feel like Andy Richter on the Conan show.
I feel like I'm hearing the voice of God.
Really?
See you.
Well, I've been taking voice lessons.
Oh.
Hey, I'm gonna leave the podium for a second here. Hey, you know, you want to tell the visitors, the listeners, the viewers where we are?
Yes, we're at the San Diego Repertory Theater, the Lyceum downtown.
And we're in the Space Theater.
Yep.
And have you noticed how spacious it is?
It is spacious.
Yeah.
Probably seats about 350 people in here.
It's a space theater.
That's why it's for spacey people.
Right.
So we're in the right place.
Exactly. Yeah. And now you have lined up a whole bunch of people for the show, right?
Yes.
And we want to talk about last week. We were out at the Wings over Gillespie.
And I heard that was fun. You got some close contact with the airplanes?
They were right behind us.
Yeah.
So I'm just catching up. I'm working on those episodes. So probably by the time you see this, all those episodes will be up. And you can find those on the website at the talk
of San Diego.com.
And so you can check that out. And next week, you know where we're going to be next week?
No.
We're going to be at Glorieta Bay Inn.
Okay.
And that is...
what are you doing over there?
We're going to do a show. We're going to do this TV / radio show. It's called The Talk.
Of San Diego.
And we're going to have some fun over there. And then just a couple of days after that, like that's on a Friday, and then on a Monday, we're doing a rare Monday show, and that's going to be at the San Diego Yatchit Club.
What, so you're actually going to get up out of bed on a Monday?
Yes.
Wow.
I'm not going to bed. I'm just going to stay up from Friday to Monday.
I was going
to
say.
I'm just going to stay down there on Shelter Island
because
they're both on Shelter Island. And we're going to have food from Fiddler's Green. They're going to bring us some food, so that'll be nice.
Nice.
And also, we want to thank the folks from Panda Inn for bringing us food today. And that is on the way. You like Chinese food?
I do.
Who doesn't? Who doesn't?
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah.
Jinx.
And so you have a few guests lined up here. And there's one gentleman, he's sitting next to you, and he's being nice and quiet and behaving himself. And so just waiting. He's waiting. And so after the song, do you know who did this song?
It's like U2 or something.
Like U2.
One of those guys.
Yeah, it's got a funny name to it. When you hear it, it'll be more like an aha moment. Oh, I gave it away, didn't I? Man, I'm terrible at giving clues.
I'm going to ask about an aha moment today at some point.
Oh, okay. Did you have fun getting down here?
Yeah, you know, for me, I've been here a bunch of times, so I'm pretty familiar with the space.
There you go.
Our technician, not so much.
Well, you know.
He had a bad day. It's okay.
Yeah, he's
here.
We
still love him.
Yeah, oh, we love him to death. Are you
kidding
me? We're
going to have a hug fest.
Well, I wouldn't go that far. But a firm handshake.
We're going to have a firm handshake off.
There you go. So we're going to take a break.
Yep.
And then when we come back, you're going to talk to a gentleman, and his name is?
Todd Salovey.
And he does?
He's the artistic director of the Lipinksy Family San Diego Jewish Arts Festival.
Does that have anything to do with the background that we have going on?
Yes, we coordinated that.
Oh, okay. That's
good. Kind of fancy.
All right, so we're going to be right back. And this is Johnny.
And this is Susanna.
With the talk
of San Diego.
If you go to Wikipedia and look up the word lasagna, it's defined as a wide, flat pasta shape and refers to a dish made with this type of pasta with different sauces and baked in the oven. But if you come to Giant Pizza King, we define it as a hot, delicious blend of fresh handmade pasta, garden fresh tomato sauce, spicy Italian sausage, along with a secret blend of spices handed down from generation to generation, combined with the finest Italian cheeses, all to make it the best lasagna in Imperial Beach. So what are you waiting for? Look at that! That's Giant Pizza King in Imperial Beach with not one, but two convenient locations to serve you.
Sausage you want! Sausage! You want it? No one wants.
$10 Mall. It has it all. That's right, $10 Mall has it all, and all for under $10. We've got men's, we've got women's, we've got kids, and accessories galore. Makeup, scarves, watches, and all? That's right, under $10. So check it out. Go to $10mall.com now and start saving today. And be sure to tell a friend and earn extra bonus points. Remember, $10 Mall has it all.
Hi, Susanna.
Hi, Johnny.
Hey, do you like $10 Mall?
I do.
Why do you like $10 Mall?
Oh, they've got it all.
They have it all, yes. Exactly. So we need to get you over there one of these days and get you a new outfit, huh?
Yeah, I got a couple of, I got a couple of tops and things, mix and matchy type
tops?
Things in there.
Did you bring any dreidels?
I didn't bring any dreidels.
Oh, because you have a guest here. And so,
but I'm sure I have a connection. I could get one.
There you go. Yeah. Now, maybe you would like to introduce this gentleman.
Of course. So here sitting next to me, this handsome man here is Todd Salovey. He's the artistic director of the Lipinksy Family San Diego Jewish Arts Festival. Welcome to the
show. Thank you. Great to be here.
And so this year is a very special anniversary, isn't
well,
it?
Well, amazingly, it's the 20th year of the festival.
Wow.
Never kind of thought I'd be running it for 20 years.
Yeah.
But I'm really proud of it and excited about the work we're doing this year.
So you started as a teenager then?
I started when you were a teenager. I was older than that then.
And so the festival has brought together artists from, 13 different countries. You've produced numerous world premieres and presented work in 7 different languages. Is there anything else like it in the region?
Well, it's a good question because there are a lot of Jewish festivals and there's some really wonderful ones around the country. But the model for most Jewish festivals is you find somebody talented or somebody whose name you know and you book them in and they do a show and then they leave. And we don't really work that way. I think as being part of San Diego Rep, we really value the creative part, the new part of producing anything. And so we do a lot of shows and programs here that are created just for this festival.
So you actually, I mentioned that you do a lot of world premieres, they're actually built and created here in San Diego with this community?
Well, we just did one this week that you know very well, built and created for here, and we're working on another one that's going to happen next week. What I love is that much of the work starts here, and then it goes to other places around the country. This is the birthplace for a lot of new Jewish work.
So you have some shows, do you have some shows touring at all already for this season?
Several of the plays that we've premiered here in the festival have had very healthy lives outside of the festival. An example is a play that I wrote and directed called The Blessing of a Broken Heart. Now, most of the work is not directed and written by me. This isn't a vanity festival.
It's not a Todd Fest?
Well,
I'm disappointed.
Yeah, I want my family to come so I don't make it about myself. So that is a play that I did based on a book that was written about a family in Israel. And it was awarded an Edgerton Award for New American Play. We developed it here in the festival. We then did it in the Rep season. And it has subsequently been on the East Coast several times, theaters around the country. And it's really exciting to me as an artistic director to create something new that has a life here and is seen elsewhere.
And do you collaborate with other Jewish festivals around the country? Do you have any sort of contacts out there that you work with to help develop
this? Yeah, it's very interesting. There's a kind of a Jewish network, and we touch base with each other, and we try to share ideas.
What would you say is what was your original vision, if you can remember when you started this? What is it that you wanted to happen?
Well, you know what's funny is that I didn't really know much about Jewish festivals when I started, and I certainly did not know what the Jewish audience liked. And
because the Jewish audience can be very diverse. They can be from very conservative to very liberal.
Well, that's nicely
like any
said.
Audience,
exactly. I mean, in the same way that people think of, well, we're going to do a show for the Latino audience.
Yeah.
That's not one thing. It's certainly not one thing.
Right.
And what's interesting, I found, is that you have to say what it is that you're doing, because not every person is going to be attracted to everything that you're doing. doing. Mm-hmm. And you want the people that are going to love the work that you, a certain piece, to come to that piece. And, you know, I think it should also be said that not only Jewish people come to the festival and see our work. And I think what's exciting to me is that, you know, we're looking at art forms and issues and stories that have a broad appeal to audiences throughout different communities.
Is it kind of trial and error and kind of adjust it from year to year?
Yes, I think as an artistic director, you're always learning from what works well and what doesn't, but you're also trying to take some chances and do things that you don't know how they're going to go. I'll give you an example. So this year, we did a show called the Klezmer Summit. Every year, we do a big Jewish music show about klezmer music, which is traditional European-based Jewish party music. And it's played on classical instruments, but it's a folk form. And we've done very traditional klezmer shows many years. This year, because San Diego Rep just did a show called Federal Jazz Project, we decided to do a program called Jews and Jazz. So I had no idea how a klezmer show about jazz was going to go over. And in fact, klezmer lovers tend to be a little orthodox about their klezmer. The first time I did a klezmer concert, many people left it in the middle, saying to me, "That's not klezmer." As I said, I learned by doing it. And so I didn't know how klezmer and jazz would go over this year. Turned out to be one of our biggest selling klezmer summits ever.
Wow.
And people loved it. And we had a variety of musicians, including Gilbert Castellano,
yep,
who was the favorite.
Yes, he's a wonderful local trumpeter favorite and internationally recognized. I'm surprised he stays in San Diego. Everybody always says that about him.
He's a jazz treasure.
And I love how you're mixing Jewish and non-Jewish performers as well into all of it. I think you have, we can talk about it a little later, but you have an upcoming show with Herbert Seguenza, who is also...
We're going to take a break.
Time you're in Imperial Beach, you've got to stop in at Jersey Boys Diner, where East meets West. Jersey Boys Diner has everything from Philly cheesesteaks to chicken fried steaks. Breakfast, lunch, or dinner, the boys have got you covered. Along with snacks, cookies, and the coldest beer in town, you'll feel right at home whether you're a transplant or a local. Jersey Boys Diner is located at 875 Seacoast Drive, Imperial Beach. We'll see you there.
Hey, Susanna.
Hey, Johnny.
Guess what?
We're back.
We're back, and we will see you there. Hey, do you know about Roku?
Roku is where we can be found, this wonderful show.
Exactly. And if you want to get on Roku, Roku is a streaming device, so you can stream audio and video and even your music on Amazon now through the Roku device. And if you want to watch the talk
of San Diego,
you can go to Discover Video, and that is where we have our channel. And if you have something that you would like to have a show on, you know, maybe you have an organization or a company and you want to have your own TV show like us, you go to discovervideo.com and they'll hook you up. They'll tell you how much it costs to have your show broadcast on the Roku. And I was listening to K-Earth 101, and they're running ads on K-Earth 101 for Roku. So it's getting more popular. They have over 750 channels on the Roku.
There's no need to have cable.
Not anymore.
No.
And so we had to take a break real abrupt there.
Yeah.
But that's okay because our guest, Todd, is still here.
Yes.
Right?
And run off.
Not yet.
Scared.
So, Todd, you having fun?
Oh, yeah. Blast.
Oh, yeah. I'm telling you. So you had asked a question, and we had gotten cut off. So maybe you could re-ask.
Yeah, we started to talk about how you were mixing Jews and non-Jews into the mix in terms of the performers that you have, and you wanted to mention a little more about that.
Well, a lot of Jewish festivals like to have Jewish performers who do work that's not Jewish. I like that our festival explores Jewish ideas, Jewish history, Jewish traditions, Jewish art, Jewish-related art forms. And sometimes the great performers of that are not Jewish. So we very often will have performers who are not Jewish doing Jewish-themed work.
Yeah. And I'd love for you to just tell us a little bit about why this festival means so much to you personally.
Wow. I guess because for a lot of reasons. I guess, first of all, because creativity means a lot to me, and being Jewish means a lot to me. And the fact that this is exploring what it means to be Jewish and who Jewish people are and what our history is and what our worldview is through creativity and what our future is through creativity is really exciting to me. And I guess it also means a lot to me because I love that it gives people in the Jewish community an opportunity to feel proud about being Jewish and having Jewish voices seen by many communities in a very positive spirit.
So you didn't know how this was going to start. You are now in your 20th year. What do you see as the future of this festival? Where do you see it in 5, 10 years? Or what would you like to see happen? Have you thought about that?
Well, Susanna, we did our work earlier this week called Women of Valor. And it's a piece about inspiring women in San Diego. And as you know, I co-write that piece with my daughter, Leia, with Ali Viterbi, with Rebecca Myers, all of whom are under 22. And I guess what I would love to do is start to hand off parts of the festival to younger people who are looking at the different art forms, different ideas, and just let it flourish into the future.
Yeah. You don't know where the future is going to take us in these young minds, technology sort of inclined young minds, and excellent writers, by the way. And you also have some North County venues that you work with, right?
It's one of the things we've been doing the last couple of years is branching out into North County. So a lot of our work is here at the Lyceum Theater, but we also do work throughout North County in different venues. We've done something in Oceanside Museum of Art. We have something coming up in about a week and a half at Temple Solel. I love doing great work in interesting places.
So tell us two things. Number one, where we can find more information. So give us the website.
So the REP's website is sdrep.org.
Okay. And then also, you have a couple of shows coming up that we definitely want to plug. So we've got one, Soul Farm. Tell us a little bit about that.
So that'll be the final performance of the festival. And Soul Farm is on Tuesday, June 18th at 7:30. They are my favorite band. And I don't know exactly how to describe them, but think Israeli music, Mediterranean music, and the Grateful Dead. All combined.
That sounds right up your alley there.
That sounds like some combination. Now, is there any way that we can find their music online so we can listen to it?
Yeah, they have a great website. So Google Soul Farm, you'll go to their website and you can see them and hear them. They're a great band.
And how are you spelling that again?
Soul, S-O-U-L, and Farm, F-A-R-M, one word.
Well, there you go.
And then you've got another one before that, actually, June 13th.
So as I said, we develop a lot of new work here and get to work with interesting people. So we're working with the San Diego REP's resident artist, Herb Seguenza. Herb is really well known in San Diego as a member of Culture Clash. His specialty is political, comedic work. And he's decided to take on a brand new piece about the 60s activist Abbie Hoffman.
And he wrote the show also.
So Herb has studied a lot of Abbie's life and his writing, and Herb has written this new play.
Wow. And he's not a Jew. He's not a Jew, right?
Herb is not a Jew.
No. He's Chicano, Latino guy. And so that's what I found fascinating is that he can just
told
take
me
this.
He was Jewish.
Oh, I don't know. I'm not telling you. I'm asking you. Is he? Maybe he is. I think we're all sort of Jewish in here somewhere, you know.
If you go back far enough.
If you go back far enough, yeah, we're all sort of, somewhere related. What has been your favorite show throughout the years, in these 20 years? Have you had an aha moment? Have you had sort of a moment where you thought, wow, this is amazing, this is so great?
I guess my favorite work was a play that we did, which was based on a Hasidic mystical story called The Mad Dancers. And it was a piece that combined mystical dance, Hasidic music, and very poetic narrative. It was one of the plays that became part of the REP season and has traveled around the country. And, you know, it showed me that you could do something which is funny, entertaining, mystical, and moving, and kind of realized all the things I love about working in the theater.
And is this is festival something that you work on all year long?
I do. I work on it all year long, and I'm kind of looking for pieces. But also, people come to me all year long with ideas that they have. And
are you open to that? Can people come up to you and say, hey, I wrote this play? Or
well, people do, and yeah, I am open to it. And some great ideas we've done in the festival have come just by people approaching me.
Do you need volunteers?
What are you offering?
Well, I mean, for people in general that are watching and looking in and saying, hey, how would I get involved with this?
The best way for people to get involved with us is to think of some great Jewish performers that they've seen or some Jewish topics that they've heard about.
Any Youngman? That comes to mind.
Youngman. Yes, people that get respect.
Gilbert Gottfried. Oh, well, okay, then not Gilbert Gottfried. Okay.
No respect. What do you have one in that you're working on now for already for next year, or anything that you're excited about for?
Well, there are a couple of things that we're talking about for next year. There is a klezmer band called Klezmer San, which is the major klezmer band of Mexico City.
Oh, wow!
That we're already talking about.
There's
possibly
a very large Mexican Jewish community here in San Diego.
Here in San Diego, yeah, mm-hmm. Very strong one.
Who knew?
What's interesting is many years ago, maybe 15 years ago, I announced the festival season, and I came on stage before a pretty full house, and I said, tomorrow night's show is being done in Spanish by a group called Teatro Punto y Coma, and everyone laughed at me, and I said, well, don't laugh, it's sold out. So there's a very active Jewish, Spanish-speaking arts community here.
Well, Todd, we really want to thank you for taking the time out of your schedule to come out here.
My pleasure. Thanks for coming to my backyard.
And once again, give us the website where people can find out.
SDREP.org or call the box office, 619-544-1000.
Fantastic.
Thank you so much for being here.
Great to be here. Thanks.
And we're going to take a break.
Okay.
And when we come back, we're going to have another guest, huh?
Yes.
Somebody that you lined up for us.
Yes.
Fantastic. So we're going to be right back after a word from one of our lovely, lovely sponsors. And this is Jenny.
And this is Susanna.
With the Talk
of San Diego. More belong to the moment.